This video is one of several videos on the new event frame generator. It will lead you through the necessary steps for configuring events for the event frame generator tutorial. First, we'll open up the PI event frame interface manager. First thing to do is add an interface, the service ID. It's important, and also to find the interface, so click on the search, navigate to the PI/PC interfaces EFGen, and then select PI/EFGen.exe. The next step is to do the file selection. There are two files, the ini file and XML file, which are used for the configuration information. Navigate to the PI interfaces EFGen directory and take the PIEFGensim.ini file. This has predetermined settings for the tutorial. When you open it, because there are some things which are hard-coded, like the PI server and the AF server, the system is trying to connect to those. So be patient, this takes maybe 10 to 20 seconds or so, and it will come back and tell us that it cannot connect and find the AF database. Okay, so it's come back and told us that the AF server has not been specified or is valid. So now we will correct that by going to the server information tab, and we'll select the PI server and the AF database. So go ahead and select your PI server, and then go and do a search for the AF server settings. In my case, I will connect to my AF database and then find the database call PIEFGensim, PIEFGensim. Go to the operational settings and interface ID, change it to 1. We will see the importance of this in the next video. Now go to the event frame structure. Oh, and also make sure that you have real-time set in your operational settings. Over here you can see pre-configured events that are being set up. You'll have a name for the actual event. Then you have a template. So this is from the event frame template that you've created. So in this case, this has already been pre-decided for you in the tutorial. Next part is the active point. So this is the PI tag that will look at a digital or a string change and look at using a behavior, either pulse or step. And you can find more information about this in the manual. Then you have the event frame name. You can use the active point value, the static name, or in this case, we will use the value of the PI point itself. In addition to the template, you can go ahead and add additional attributes for this event, which are outside of the event frame template. The last part is then go to the other settings, and you can add things like recovery time and evaluation delay to the settings. This part here is the element reference. In this case, you can see for tutorial, it is hard-coded to the preset value. You will need to go ahead and change this for your system. So we'll do an AF search and search for RE100 and select it. Go ahead now, delete the original one, and we'll have to make these corrections to the rest of the events. So good trick is to click there and then do a Control A and Control C and start copying and pasting. Now we get into the reactor 200, so make sure when you paste it you change the element to from 100 to 200. Next two are the reactor 300, so, and also for factory 2, so make sure that you change those when you paste. So make it 300 and factory 2 is the parent element. Okay, almost done. We'll do the reactor 400 now. and the downtime. Okay, now we'll go ahead and go to the batch procedures. And the second one is for reactor 300 in factory 2. So make sure you change the factory 1 to factory 2 and 300. And this last one is for reactor 400. Okay, just a few more to do now for the factory. Now we're going to set that. So this is a different element. Go ahead and do a search and look for factory. And select factory 1. And do the same procedures before. Delete this one, highlight this, control A, control copy, and then change the settings for the time hour and the time peak time. Remember, this is now factory 2, so make sure you change when you paste, change it back to factory 2. And the last two sub elements or sub events, go ahead and change right there. Okay, so now we have successfully modified all of the events that were created. Go ahead and make sure you save. This will change the settings that you've just put and save them into the INI and the XML files. Now in the service configuration, we'll need to go ahead and create a service and then to start the interface. So the first thing to do is start the service. And this will go ahead, create the service, and this will go ahead and register it. And then start the service. Now the interface is running. Now remember, we had the recovery set for a day back. So when we go to the PI System Explorer and search for the events, we should now start seeing events being generated as the recovery process is going on. So the PI System Explorer, make sure you are in the PI EFGen SIM database. Go to the event frames. Click on one of the searches, and as you'll see, we are now getting data for the system. So these are the recovered event frames that we just generated for the tutorial.